We are advancing in every field, every single second. Do you ever wonder where we are heading? What future holds for us? Is artificial intelligence really taking over the world?
Author of the bestseller book Sapiens, Yuval Noah Harari, returns with equally original, compelling book, Homo Deus, A Brief History of Tomorrow, turning his focus towards humanity's future, giving some straight answers to those who are curious about how a society is likely to make a significant attempt to gain happiness, immortality, and godlike powers. There are five core key points I'll be discussing, so let's begin.
Number 1. Humanity's faith in science and technology. Humanity always faced and struggled to overcome situations which are out of control. Although we easily overcome some threats, but some threats like famine, poverty, and war always pushed humans to the brink of collapse. As you may have noticed, our survival instincts have evolved in a way. If we see a new threat, we immediately get to work. For instance, since the corona outbreak, we have seen how humans took actions to lock down across the globe. Then we started helping people around us with food, medical aid, and financial aid for those who unfortunately lost their jobs. Plus, scientists from all over the globe are working relentlessly to develop the vaccine. We don't blame the chaos on the God anymore. Instead, we question our inability to get things under control. Similarly, Ebola virus in West Africa is a well-documented case study that showed us a situation that killed 11,000 people. It wasn't act of God, but World Health Organization's initial failure. But still, we came together and pulled resources to contain its spread. What Noah trying to say is, these events translate that humanity has the know-how and skill to prevent plagues and virus. But just imagine what we will do with all the knowledge and technology when we won't have any challenges to tackle. Noah says humans will start finding happiness, immortality, and divinity. And these three things will drive our future existence. Although this reality is a century away, but is already laying the foundation for it. In the case of immortality, we no longer believe that death is inevitable. For scientists, death is more like a technical problem arising from a faulty heart or any other unhealthy lifestyle. Doctors will explain the root cause of the death to patients with ways to fix it, like it's a glitch in the matrix. Hence, billions of dollars are invested in creating new drugs and in improving nanotech and other technologies so that can give us edge over death. Just as immortality, the quest to find happiness has become an obsession in recent years. We have right to be happy. Anything that contradicts this notion is unacceptable. And that's precisely why we are finding enjoyment in technical products. Plus, scientists are creating more drugs to generate happiness in you, biochemically. In short, more drugs, more technology. Our quest to pursuing immortality and happiness will end our establishment as a divine creature, but one who is void of pain, fear, and flaws. This is what Noah calls transformation of Homo sapiens to Homo Deus. We are not trying to reach the God level, but more like Zeus level, who controls the environment. Besides, we are coming close to achieving it by fusing man with machine, regenerating new limbs, so there are possibilities you might get chance to possess these superpowers of your favorite superhero. Which leads us to point number 2, domestication and ecological changes. We learn in the book Sapiens that agriculture revolution, which started 12,000 years ago, tells us how animals and plants contributed to the well-being of our ecosystem. On the other hand, with the help of religion, we establish gods and humans are core entities to keep the world working, and they consider animals were just soulless creatures whose role is to feed humans and keep God happy. Noah says if this were true, then pharmacologists would never rely on psychology of rat to create antidepressant drugs. But in this era, domestication continues. With all there we have is more number of animals domesticated than animals roaming the wild. Humanity is the only factor that is responsible for climate change. Noah says, our species feel we are more important than other species, and our religion is our end product, so we can access the afterlife. The only true advantage we have is our imagination for creativity. We know we can accomplish anything by putting our imagination to work. 70,000 years ago, we started implementing this process. Tribes and clans use stories and superstitions to keep people cooperating, to keep them motivated, and also to protect the value of community. People believe in myths whenever they want to bring other people together. Today we have liberalism, communism, and capitalism.
shares relatable principle. Religion asks for structure to keep human behavior in a circle. On the other hand, science leans towards creating a solution for famine, war, virus, and plague. In conclusion, religion and science brought us this far and will continue to push us to make choices that really matters. Which leads us to the next point, economic growth, the new religion. Previously, we had passive model that suggests humanity has fixed raw materials, energy, so we can determine our survival. We will stick to law, humanity, and greed, which is not something we should preach. Noah says nowadays, more, faster, and better are the solution for all the problems. It indeed boosted our economic growth, and hence we increase our level of scientific productivity. Therefore, we face the consequences of greed. Earth provides enough to satisfy man's needs, but not every man's greed. Mahatma Gandhi. And the last point, free will and AI. What future holds for us? Will robot rule the world as we see in the movies? If you are watching this video, then you are already surrounded by AI more than you can imagine. Noah says, we are a network of neurons that can translate sensation to emotions, experiencing self and narrative self. Experiencing self takes amount of your experiences, and narrative self takes those experiences and narrate it into the story or make big decisions. And these big decisions are our beliefs, depends on our experience. Author says such flawed decision-making process gave birth to AI. Our free will, more like partial liberalism, shows our final say on governance and economy, that customers and voters have final say in it. Still, our inability to provide all the answers for future generations suggest we have become useless for the future in front of AI. Sooner than later, AI will replace sapiens in almost every profession, and they will have access to all our information, and they could manipulate us without us even knowing. And the worst part of all is this technical era, which will prioritize rich over the poor. Rich will have access to all the new expensive biological upgrade, and poor will only access it when it is no longer in value. In addition to that, Noah says, this will give birth to two religions, techno-humanism and dataism. Techno-humanism will maintain humanism and will assist humans on the quest to evolve from Homo sapiens to Homo Deus, a superior human species. Dataism, on the other hand, will claim that sapiens don't have the right processing power to manage the coming world. This prophecy is becoming evident already when we cannot make sense of the information available to us. Governments and corporations are clueless and slowly introducing superpower, which will help them to pull data and utilize it. Noah says dataism isn't against humanity. We will rely on it to separate good from bad, and we will bring back God and man religion, which we once destroyed. And when the time comes, famine, plague, and war will lose their status as a human's greatest nemesis, and the far greater threats will take their place.